Now here's a very interesting guitar. It was made in 1969 by Tony Zamatis for Ronnie Lane of the Small Faces and the Faces fame. Ronnie Lane used the guitar until the 80s and then gave it to the son of his partner at the time. Although the guitar was built in 1969 for Ronnie Lane, it was Ronnie Wood of the Faces who used it when the band played live. He would play slide guitar on it. Here's a still from a 1970 concert the Faces gave at the 100 Club in London, showing Ronnie Wood playing slide on the guitar. The guitar's got quite a few battle scars on it, but it has been on tour with the Faces in America. Don't be fooled into thinking this is a solid piece of wood either. It's actually a carved top on the guitar. The guitar is hollow. You can see the two Bill Lawrence pickups on there as well. All of the engraving on the guitar, like the engraving featured on this stop piece, has been carried out by Danny O'Brien. Danny worked for Purdy Shotguns, arguably the producer of the finest shotguns in the world. Here's some of Danny's engraving on the headstock. The original headstock to the guitar was snapped off, and this replacement headstock was fitted by Jimmy Page's guitar tech. On the back of the guitar, you can see more of Danny's engraving on the neck plate. I must tell you though, Tony Zamatis never made a bolt-on neck. This was done purely for decoration for a few special customers, mostly the Faces, and also Ronnie Wood continues the tradition in the Rolling Stones. I sent Danny O'Brien detailed photographs of the engraving, and he kindly confirmed that all the engraving was his own work. As you can see, the neck has seen a bit of action. It's been in the wars quite a bit, but still stays in tune. The Grover open back machine heads do a very good job. Here's a photograph of Ronnie Lane on stage, circa 1981, playing the guitar. The photograph was taken by Mark Hurd. As a matter of interest, the person in the background playing the Telecaster Deluxe is Mick Green of the Pirates. The guitar has a 2-octave neck and an ebony fingerboard. This is no relic guitar. All of the marks on it are from years on the road. Thank you.